We found love in a hopeless place. This drink right here goes out to all my girlfriends and everybody who believed in me and knew I could do it and knew I'd get back, and I did it. I did it, man. I'm not a failure. I can do a lot of things that a lot of people can't think I can fucking do, but I fucking did it, man. I'm gonna tell you, it almost killed me, but I did it. So fuck you, motherfuckers. I'd like to see one of y'all do what I've done. Go through what I went through. It was torture. But I had a goal in mind, and that was to make some money. Better myself a little bit. and I had to take the chance. And I just had to, man. You know what I mean? It was too easy of a chance not to take, no matter what the risk. As long as my safety was not impaired, or, you know, my health, and everything, every fucking thing, man, my safety, my health, every fucking thing was fucked up from the fucking get-go, because these assholes don't give a fuck. They wanted fucking viewers, man. No one cared about if someone lived or died or nothing, man. It was the craziest thing I ever saw in my life. There was no security. There was no, nothing. It was just no secure, nothing. It was just, I don't know. He spent more on cameras than he did about on anything. This guy's nuts, man. Yeah? Real talk. I'm gonna tell y'all something. As sure as I live, this is real talk, man. Of everybody that I hung out with, I'm gonna tell you, if you want an authentic, real broadcaster, it's BTF. Billy is a good man. And don't ever doubt me on this. I swear to you, he is, but my God in heaven, he's even fed up with this shit, because I heard him say this morning before I was leaving for the plane that, you know, the only reason he even stayed was because of his friends and his fans, or he'd be gone. He can't put up with this shit either. He's fed up with it. Everybody was fed up with it. Everybody that had any common sense. And I'm going to tell you something. When I got out that fucking door and I sat out there, Alfie David's employees, the ones who are running the shit behind the scenes, they all came up to me and had me on the back and said, Vicky, get the fuck out of here, man. You don't belong here. Get out of here, Vicky. So if you think that what I'm saying to you is a joke, it's not. It's a real talk, man. Hey, Rachel. Is she in here by me? Where's she going? Why the fuck? speech in my mind. Oh, fuck, man. I got that many people in my channel. Oh, shit. I was looking down and said, what's all these shadows in here for? Why aren't these mods, man? They're all fucking mods already. Sorry. Oh, the shadows are big on all the jet. Good God, the fucking invisible people. I learned how to dance, though. I learned how to dance, man. Hey, Mark, I love you too, dude. Let's go. Oh, let's go, man. I learned how to dance when I was away. I learned not to be afraid to dance. And, it's always a good time. It's always a good time. I'm allowed to dance. Woo! Hey, look at this, man. This is some shit here. I fell at the fucking airport, man. Thought of busting my fucking knee and shit. Can you see it? Hell, I can't see it. Let Vaughn catch up to me. Hey, Pink Bunny, how are you? It's good to see you. Yeah, right there. It's right here. Really fucked up, man. And, holy shit, man. I thought I was gonna fucking die. And Jimmy was so fucking drunk. I said, Jimmy, oh, I'm so tired of sitting. I said, when I fell, I said, give me your hand, Jimmy. And he's like, oh my God, Vicky, are you all right? Are you all right? Oh my God. I was like, shut the fuck up, man. Just give me your hand. Just help me out, man. And he was like, spazzing out and shit, you know? And I was like, oh, Jimmy. Just get me the fuck up. And he couldn't get me up, see? And once I hit that breezeway or wherever the fuck it is it takes to the plane. Just some, like, I don't know what it is about Atlanta and their little walkways, but like the middle of it is like really cool, and like the ends of it have this like metal strip running up the side, and if you get like your shoe just like a cunt hair off one way or the other, you're going down. And that's real talk, all right? And you have to understand that I'm babysitting Tommy right now, because I have to get him on the fucking plane. He smells and reeks of fucking alcohol. And I'm shoving candy and syrups down his throat so people don't smell his breath, you know? I'm like, oh, God. You know, this is just... But Jimmy was a gentleman the whole time. Jimmy was. And I'm going to tell you, me and him... We'll never be best of friends, but he's okay, you know. He's alright. He didn't hurt me, and he didn't slap me. And I'm gonna tell you, if a man would have slapped me, I'd have cried. So I don't think I could have took it. I'd have took the slap, but I'd have cried. Because I didn't want to be out of the game at that point. You know, I had too much to lose. But when Joe attacked me sexually, that was it. Man, I was like, I can't let this guy just... I've never been touched like that in my life. And I know that sounds crazy, but it's the truth. And it's my first lost his fucking mind, and he's like, wow. He lost his fucking mind, man. And I'm like, calm down, let's get through this. He's like, I gotta get you out of there. I'm trying. I got the police coming. They won't come. And I'm like, okay. And, yeah. Nancy and Bruce were the only two people that gave a rat's ass whether I lived or died that night. They're the only two people besides Lily. And Lily don't count because she's an employee of Battle Band. But Nancy and Bruce are the only two people. Nancy Jane called Bruce. And Nancy Jane was as furious as Bruce was. And I don't want anybody to ever call her a troll again. Because I wasn't out of the house and I didn't know anything. I was still inside of that torture chamber. When Bruce was going and trying to get me out of there. Because I said, you'll know when I'm done to Bruce. I said, I'll stand up at the camera and I'll say, Bruce, save me. But this time I couldn't say save me. Because it had done got past the point of saying that. Because I was being attacked by the employees of Balcon. Not just the people in the game, but Alki David is not a participant in this game. That'd be like Allison Grodner of Big Brother coming in and playing as a contestant on Big Brother. And that'd be like the voice announcer of Big Brother coming in and playing Joe. And beating the fuck out of me, literally trampling my ass, and then sexually assaulting me. It was absolutely the most surreal thing I ever experienced in my life. And I told Bruce, when I called him from East LA, they took us to an abandoned warehouse, and I went into the bathroom to change into my costume or whatever the fuck it was that they gave us, these jailbird shit, and I went in there, and I fixed and closed the door so I could change. Trying to follow the rules. And Joe came in and I was like, what's going on? You know? Because he's like the host of the show. So I looked at him with what you would call trust. And he attacked me. He smashed me up into the corner of a bathroom and was kissing all over my neck. And he says, you know you like it. You know you don't get victim. And I'm gonna tell you that I felt like this is it. That they brought me all the way out here to rape me. Legally. And from the time we got to the warehouse, until the time we got to the battle camp house. I was tortured by men and women. So I'm going to tell you, no one could have went through what I went through. There's not one woman that I know that would have done it. Mm-mm. Nope. Mm-mm. And my trolling days are over. I'm just going to sit around and cast whatever the fuck I want to do. I don't give a shit. But this stuff with battle cam is very dangerous. And Alki David is very dangerous. And if you don't know what you're doing, you're in a lot of fucking trouble. Just like I did. And I know y'all think what happened to me may be nothing, but to me, it was the most terrifying experience of my life. And what's sad is it didn't even happen inside of the game. It happened by a Battle King employee. So when you think that Battle Cam is cool and Battle Cam is great and yeah, let's go over there and troll, just remember there's real people behind that screen. And it's really, really bad having people do people. I went to the police station in Beverly Hills. I am going to press charges against Joe for physical abuse and sexual abuse. No one deserves to be abused like that. No one. And I don't give a fuck who you are. He could have venereal diseases. He touched me on my neck. He was kissing me. And everything. And it just, I had no self-defense. I had nothing. There was nowhere I could go. There was nothing I could do. Until he would just automatically stop voluntarily, all I could do was just fight him off until I was out of breath. Which only took 10 seconds? I don't know how it's serious. They do take it way too serious. Well, I understand that Joe had a job to do, but he also has a mind of his own. And when I was sitting out in the studio, I wasn't on the set. In other words, I wasn't on the battle camp house. I had done left the set, got out of that room, and was sitting in the studio. Joe magically seemed to find a way to open up the door, and he looked out the door, and I was, for some reason, looking that direction. And he looked at me, and I could tell in his eyes that he knew that he was a bad boy. Real talk. That's not my problem. That's his problem. He needs to get counseling. And he needs to realize that you can't treat me like that. Under any circumstances. No way should any man run and tackle a woman and touch her breast and do that without permission. It's just not right. I was sexually assaulted and I was physically assaulted by an employee about him. And I'm going after Joe. And I told the police, and I told Bruce, and I'm telling you, and I'm telling everybody, that I don't give a shit. No man has a right to abuse a woman like that. Period. You need to find me. I have not had any alcohol literally basically since Monday. I've had to be really careful. Well, the police asked me some very, 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 very serious questions. And I almost felt like I almost felt like what I went through wasn't as bad as I thought it was, because I wasn't. They asked me if he penetrated me and stuff like that. And I felt like, oh my God, here I go again with these weird questions, you know. It's a terrible experience to have a man that you don't know and you don't love and you don't care about run up to you out of the blue and just start touching you for shits and giggles on cam. And he's not even a contestant or a participant in the game show. It's really fucking crazy. Oh shit, I miss Miss Scruffy leaving. God damn it. Yes, 286. Good night, 397. Sleep well, dream. How can I be making up any of this? It all happened live on television. Don't even start that. I'm not going to be afraid. I'll tell you right now. I'm not afraid of anything. I'm telling the truth. I ain't got nothing to lie about. Anyway, folks, I love you, Mark. I love you, Laker Girl, Granny, Joy, Peachy, Queen Bee, Treese, and Zoink. Green Dog, Caster Troy, Mark, Mac, Mark Sr., Nedford, Pink Bunny, Strappy, Killer Blinks, and Rob. I gotta go pee. I'll be right back. Thank you.
baby. Good boy. Good boy. Good boy.
And let me tell you something. The second we got there, man, this is real talk, the second we got there, man, I'm allowed to talk about my experience. That's one thing I'm allowed to talk about. Let me tell you what happened, man. This is the craziest thing I've ever seen in my life. And please someone explain to me what this means. And I'm not trying to yell at anybody, I just don't understand it because I've never seen it before. But I'm sure y'all are going to fucking tell me. And if you're a guest, you know, you can check this out. Okay, Rachel, you're banned. Have a nice day, Mitch. I told you, girl. I said, leave me alone and don't talk to me anymore. And what did you do? Joe is Skyping Rachel right now. And Rachel is giving me the messages. So, Joe, if you're watching this channel right now, I think it's best that you know that I am coming after you for your sexual assault and your physical assault on me. I don't know what country you come from, but in the United States of America, it is illegal by law to abuse a woman. Period. And it's illegal to abuse a man and children too. Dogs, cats. And if you think for 1 minute that I'm afraid of you, I'm not. You hurt me. I'm in excruciating pain physically on my body just from your attacks. Not to mention the fact that you touched my body in a sexual way that most men don't even get. I cut her close to getting a chance to do it. I think you're a disgusting, vile human being. And you're going to be put in jail. And I hope I can get you there. Because what you've done to me will last in my mind for eternity. I don't give a shit. Well, I know what I was gonna tell you. Them Mexican women, man. This was no shit, man. We got into the Vatican house and they were introducing all, you know, you gotta do this and you gotta show that and all that. I'm like, okay. So I'm like trying to stay out of the crosshairs because I know this is gonna be Alki David versus Vicky. I know it, I can feel it, I see it coming, I knew it. So they introduced the macaroni and cheese and fucking chicken noodle shit. And then two Mexican women, Lucy Liu and Celeste, went over there and ate like fucking five boxes a piece of these fucking Lipton noodle cup of soup shit. And I'm thinking, holy fuck, man. Is that really that kind of like fucking fancy food or what? And then I started thinking, well, goddamn, maybe I need to go over there and eat me some macaroni and cheese, you know, because shit, I may wake up and not have anything to eat. Next thing I know, I look on the floor and you got fucking cup of noodles fucking all over the goddamn place, under the table, under the fucking gel bunk bed. Over by the cigarette, I'm cleaning up all the fucking cup of noodle shit, and the fucking toilet's running over. I said, okay, I'm not doing this. I cleaned up all the fucking cup of noodle shit off these goddamn poor dogs that are fucking, I mean, they were like they've never ate cup of noodles in their life. And that Barbie killer, she was gonna fuck her way through this show. I can promise you that. No doubt about it. I had no idea what I was getting myself into. Really. But it still doesn't. It's against the law to hurt a woman, man, or an animal the way that I was abused. And I am not gonna stand for it. I'm not. I'm not gonna allow it. I would have cut my hair off before I would have let some man kiss me. And that spin the bottle thing, Alki David wanting people to kiss. And that's why Lucy Liu was tapping me on my foot underneath the table. And I told her I'm not gonna do it. I said, I'm not gonna do it. I didn't drink one shot of vodka. I didn't drink nothing. And I didn't touch nobody, I didn't kiss nobody, and I wasn't going to. And I went over and got under the monk bed thing, and Lucy Liu came over. I said, don't sit by me. I said, no. And she went over and sat in like a little chair behind the gel table, and she looked at me, and I'm going to tell you, this could have been a really, really, really bad thing. Because people were too psyched up or something. I don't know. Fuck. Well, I'm sure y'all can see me, but I can't see you. Home crash. But so anyway, I just want to say to everybody that after the recent experience that I had with BattleCam.com and the affiliates and everybody associated with Alki David, I will not be casting anymore. as soon as all this is over with, I will speak my mind and tell you exactly what's going on. But I got to be extremely reserved. So I will be. But I'm going to tell you something. It was bad, folks. Off camera and on camera, it was really, really bad. If you were not a girl that would easily give up your pussy and kiss somebody, anybody, and let them, you know, like, let any man just come up and rub your vagina and stuff like that, then you aren't going to make it. No way. And the first target, and I knew from the way I was getting, I knew it was me. I knew it was me. And it was me. But that's okay. You know, Elky was dealt a hand of four aces. He was playing five card draw. He was dealt four aces, and he threw all four aces away. And was dealt four more cards. And he fucking blew. And that's not my problem. That's his problem. But I will not lose the best friend of my life. Bruce said I would lose his heart if I ever went back to battle camp after all this. And I won't hurt him for nothing. But I love you all for supporting me. I want to tell all my supporters and all my friends that I love you very, very, very much. And thank you for supporting me and believing in me and knowing and thinking that I could get out there when nobody thought I would even go. I made it. I did it. I did it. It almost fucking knocked me on my ass, but I did it. I wonder where Tommy's at and why he hasn't come in and said hi to me and said something. Thank you. it's this. Without the space. It only feels like 12 o'clock, man. I'm like completely, I'm jet lagged really bad. Oh man, when I wake up in the morning, everything will be all right. Stay up now. Oh, I'm not tired. I'm not. I'm exhausted. I had a good meal on the plane. A little expensive for a sandwich, but I sure did need it. Hadn't ate. I was hungry. I guess the people in the Balkan place doesn't eat when normal, at normal times when other people eat, you know. You eat when Alki David says you can eat, you know, right? That ain't good enough for me. Because my thoughts was, I thought we had to earn the food. And I thought you had to earn the beds and the showers. And then when I get there, there's no beds, there's no showers, and there's no food. I mean, everything was aligned in that contract that I signed. There is no Balkan House Productions, there's nothing. It's all that's true. I asked the Beverly Hills cop, this is the truth, I asked him, I said, do you know who Alki David is? He said, no. I said, well, he's supposed to be some billionaire from Beverly Hills. He said, well, no, we don't know him. And I was like, oh, really? That really kind of threw me for a loop. Because who the fuck really is Alki David?